as one of those episodes begins, that there is absolutely no point in complaining or resisting, because if I don't accept this, sooner or later security is going to be called and I will be worse off than I was before. It was not always like this. I know it wasn't. I can remember when it wasn't. What I can't remember is, at any stage, asking for the changes that have happened or being asked if I wanted them. They just happened and now they're here. And how true that is. We don't get asked anything. We get told and dictated to, like the proper slaves we are to these people. The article goes on. And while there will be some outrage in the newspapers about the spying episodes, since newspapers are one of the last places where common sense survives, nothing will change. Other couples will be spied on in the same way, under the same law, which will not be changed. So let us look at this case and see why it happened. First of all, the spying. A foreign is immensely powerful in this country now. It has hidden itself in a tangle of interlocking authorities, effectively nationalised and Europeanised, and run by people whose name we will never find out. There is no scrutiny. The main political parties are dead things, job creation schemes for people who can't make it anywhere else. Where independence is punished, the law is beyond the reach of most of us. Then there's the question of the school. Everyone knows that the official propaganda about education is a lie. We do not have a comprehensive school system. We have a pretend. A viciously unequalled selective system which fails hundreds of thousands of children from the beginning. I can relate to this part in the article, because people nowadays don't have the intellect and brain power they used to have years ago. This is a dumbing down and a brainwashing of our children to a government system. Just remember, people, your kids spend loads of times at school, and then when they come home and they get bored, a lot of people complain that the government should be doing more for them, to give them more things to do. Is this really what we need? Especially as you look around in society today. And we finance these organisations, schools, and weapons to detectors. We finance it all. And then they use it all against us. I'll carry on with the article. Selection is done by money and influence. And people try to cheat by singing hymns and saying prayers they don't believe, by renting flats in catchment areas or lying about their circumstances. Replacing this with a just system based on merit is ruled to be politically impossible and cruel. So the unfairness has to be maintained and policed by snooping. This has happened for years. If only people would realise that they use taxpayers' money to stake out people's homes and follow them about. So there it is, lies, unaccountable authority, and the seeds of a secret police force. Check in today on school catchment areas, and tomorrow on what? One thing's for sure, you'll find out too late. The next news article is from the Telegraph. All UK citizens in ID database by 2017. All British citizens will have their fingerprints and photographs registered on a national ID database within 10 years under plans outlined by the government. Millions in sensitive jobs, including teachers, carers and health workers, will be among the first to be entered onto the identity register. In a bid to kickstart the project, the world's biggest foreign nationals working in Britain will begin to be issued with cards from November, starting next year. the first British citizen will be enrolled, beginning with some airport staff, power station employees and people working on the London Olympic site. It's a bit of a bummer. Looks like I won't be doing no more work on that site from next year. Fingerprint kiosks, modelled on existing photograph booths in stations and shops, could be set up around the country to help people enrol. Plans outlined by Jacqueline Smith, the Home Secretary, yesterday said a fee of £30 for a standard card and more than £100 for a combined ID and passport. I love to say the way it's an enrolment. It's an enrolment plan. The said in the news articles from these papers, from the words of Jacqueline Smith, that we will have these cards. It's not enrolment. They're going to force you to have it. They'll bring it in tiptoe style. I'll carry on though. But ministers have been told by their own experts that enrolment should be free if the scheme is to win hearts and minds. Oh, there's that war phrase again, hearts and minds. That's what we do at war, innit? We win the hearts and the minds of the people, like in Iraq. I'll carry on with the article. A report commissioned by Gordon Brown from Sir James Crosby, a former banking chief, raised the prospect of the taxpayer stumping up the full cost. The government has insisted all along that a multi-billion pound scheme would be funded through fees and not taxes. Sir James also came out against including a digital image of the cardholder's fingerprint on the microchip in each ID card for security reasons. The card and database should only hold some elements of a biometric, he said. His report was published alongside a new government timetable for introducing a universal ID scheme by 2017. From the start of 2010, young people will be able to get an identity card if they choose, and will be issued with a unique personal identity number. Later that year, the scheme will be opened up to voluntary applicants of any age. From 2012, after the next general election, anyone applying for a new passport will automatically be fingerprinted, and 49 pieces of personal information logged on the database. This is 3 years later than planned, when the scheme was first proposed after the September 11th attacks.
Thursdays on the Edge.
Made our love on wasteland through